The COVID-19 pandemic has forced colleges to adapt like never before, and it's continuing to alter the way millions of American students are receiving instruction. Jeffrey Brown looks at the effects of those changes and what they could mean in the future. It's part of our ongoing series, Rethinking College.
Empty campuses, eerily quiet classrooms, unused dormitories. A new normal in a time of pandemic. But even before COVID hit, this was a vision some colleges were confronting.
College students and faculty have been forced into remote Zoom classes around the country this year, of course. But here at small Unity College in central Maine, they were already moving in that direction, part of longer-term changes in higher education, not just to survive a pandemic, but to survive at all.
We as an industry were a little bit in denial, in my opinion.
Melek Peter Khoury is Unity's president.
The tier one institutions are in a league of their own. But for the rest of us, I think some noticed that something had to change. We just decided to start looking at those changes before it became a problem, which is harder. Sometimes it is easier for institutions to make change when in crisis.
Founded in 1965, Unity is a private liberal arts college known for its environmental studies focus and hands-on experience.
Unity College is America's environmental college.
But Khoury says even before the pandemic, lower enrollment and higher costs were making its traditional model unsustainable, threatening the college's future.
So I wanted to show some of the field experience.
He began to rethink how instruction could be delivered, including remotely. Then came the pandemic.
We basically lost $12 million in revenue overnight, having to send everyone home. Lucky for us, 5 years prior, we had started to invest in technology. So we were able to allow students to continue their education, just not how they started. So our distance education students were fine. Our residential students were really upset by it.
Unity is certainly not alone. While the vast majority of colleges have announced plans to return to more normal operations next fall, many are still facing dire financial forecasts going forward. Across the country, more than 60 colleges have closed or merged since 2016. That's what Khoury says he was trying to avoid when Unity announced major changes over the summer, laying off or furloughing about 30% of its staff and shifting permanently to an online and hybrid model. It didn't sit well with some students.
I was willing to be online for the fall, for the pandemic, and just keep everyone safe, but anything further than that, you know, that just wasn't what I signed up for.
20-year-old Delana Kerwin came to Unity in 2019 to study wildlife and fisheries biology. But she decided to leave last fall and transfer elsewhere.
Why was the traditional college experience important to you?
So that I could directly talk with my professors and go to their office hours, as well as like the different study groups that they had, because you can't really simulate, you know, working with animals on a computer. And so that was extremely important, that I get that hands-on experience so that I can, you know, do the best in my career one day.
And this is something that comes up when you design a survey.
But Unity's move to hybrid learning was exactly what 42-year-old Joshua Tate was looking for. A father to a 3-year-old son, Tate is a sophomore.
It has been very beneficial to me. When I started out my first term in Unity College, we only had one car and my girlfriend was using it to go to work, so I really needed something that I could do from home and also be a caretaker for my child.
Which isn't really a distinction that you can make for all of the birds, for sure.
But Tate says he also came to Unity for opportunities like this one. He and Professor Allie McKnight recently hiked several miles into nearby woods as part of an ornithology class. The goal on this night was to survey the surrounding area for American woodcocks, a small bird that often comes out after sunset.
Almost every course I've taught this year has some big component where students have to go out to an area near wherever they are and apply the techniques that we're learning about, so they're not just reading about things and watching videos.
Welcome to Environmental Justice.
Some Unity professors, like Katara Moore, are also happy with the new flexibility. Moore can now live in Philadelphia and work remotely in rural Maine.
As I'm an urban geographer, I study environmental justice in cities. And so it just would be an oxymoron in a way for me to move to Maine to work. And then plus my family is here. You know, I have a 94-year-old grandmother. My husband's job is here in Philadelphia. He's been working this job for 32 years. And so it would be no way possible for me to move to Maine.
But these changes have many upset and raise a new kind of threat to the town of Unity itself.
I think that the town is reeling right now from the loss of the students, as well as the faculty who have moved on or faculty who are now working from home.
Tamika Ajemian moved to the area 2 years ago and opened Unity Kitchen. She says the restaurant had been a popular hangout for faculty and students, but today it's barely hanging on.
I don't think that I would have bought this building and started this business if there wasn't something here that I thought would help support us and help us grow, which is the school, because there really isn't anything else here.
Unity President Khoury admits the move to permanent hybrid and distance learning has been both difficult and controversial. But he says offering students many options, residential, fully online, a mix of the two, even opening a new technical school, has led to record enrollment.
We've gone from a 50-year average enrollment of about 600, and we're currently at 1,600 students. Our average age at Unity College for student population for the last 50 years has been around 19. It's now almost 30.
Earlier this month, Unity announced it will reopen its campus in the fall. But Khoury says he's uncertain as to exactly how many students will return. About two-thirds of Unity students are currently enrolled in its distance education program.
I think any institution that only chooses one way to teach is on borrowed time. We have an obligation not to change the curriculum, but change how, where, and when we offer it and make it more relevant in the 21st century.
It's something colleges around the country are now grappling with. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in Unity, Maine.
And thank you for bringing us that story. Thank you, Jeff.